In this episode, we will set up a simple React application where we will later dive into each of the React hooks. As you can see, I have my console and my code editor open, and I will start by checking that I have Node.js installed, along with npm, the node package manager. So let's just type node-v, and this version should be greater than 10.16. And for npm, let's just type npm-v, and this version should be greater than 5.6. If you don't have either of those installed, don't worry, there is a link in the description to the Node.js downloads page. Now, let's create our project folder by typing mkdir, which stands for make directory, and I'll name our project react-hooks-tutorial. Let's also navigate into our project by typing cd, which means change directory, and our project name, which is react-hooks-tutorial. In here, it's time for us to set up our React application. While we could do that by ourselves and manually create Babel and Webpack configuration files, in this tutorial, I want to focus purely on React hooks, so let's just use the Create React App package, which takes care of everything for us. We can do that by typing npx create-react-app, and this last argument should be path to our project, but since we are already in it, just type dot and finally press enter. This command first installs the Create React App package and then runs it, so this may take a while. As you can see, the command has finished, and I will now open the project in my code editor. Since I use Visual Studio Code, I can do that by simply typing code-r and dot at the end, but if you are using a different editor, feel free to pause the video and open the project folder by yourself. Now, if you take a look at the project structure and the files, you might feel overwhelmed, but don't worry, I'll quickly go over them and remove the ones we don't need. Let's start by taking a look into the package.json file, and in here we can see a number of packages and also some scripts. The one we are interested in is the start script, which will start our application on localhost. It uses React scripts, which basically handle all of the code compilation for us. Now, let's take a look into the source folder. The first important file is index.js, which is the entry point for our application, and as you can see, the render function lives in here. I'm going to quickly remove this code at the bottom of the file along with the import, and I am also going to remove the file itself, which is the report web vitals.js. The next important file is app.js, where all of the important code is. Now I am going to remove all of this and replace it with a simple text of React hooks tutorial. I am also going to remove the logo import because it isn't used anymore, and I am therefore also going to remove the logo file itself. Now, the last thing to do is to remove those test files, so let's remove them. And that's it, we are finally ready to start our application on the localhost. So I am going to type npm start, and the application should open in my browser. As you can see, we have the text React Hooks tutorial, which is exactly what we wanted. And that's all for this episode. In the next one, we will finally dive into the useState hook and explore how to use it. If you have any suggestions or questions, let me know in the comments and I will answer every single one of them. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and subscribe to see more videos like this in the future. Thanks for watching.